Okay, here is the guide on how to participate in the Pulse Chain test net. There's a lot of buzz about the Pulse Chain airdrop coming. Pulse Chain team is talking about it. And a lot of the people I know, big accounts, they're pushing it on Twitter. So I'm here to show you how to get into it and to make sure you don't miss another airdrop. I was able to do what's called airdrop farming on at least three wallets on the Arbitrum airdrop. I'm sitting pretty and still holding a few hundred, a few thousand of those tokens. So we're here to show you how to get into this Pulse Chain potential airdrop coming in the future before they do the snapshot. Now we're gonna do. It says check out the brand new Explorer, claim free testnet PLS at the faucet, stake them, and try to bridge over your assets from the Ethereum Rinkeby testnet. We're not going to do the bridge. The bridge is that'll be another video if I figure that out. It's crappy right now. So what we're going to do is go to the faucet and then stake them on the PulseNet network, DeFi network. So first thing you have to do is follow these instructions. I'll put the link for this webpage, the pulsechain.com webpage below, so you can actually copy and paste all this information into your MetaMask wallet. So first you need a MetaMask wallet. Download it from the Play Store or the iOS App Store. You're going to need to go in, follow the directions as it says here to connect to the testnet version 3, open MetaMask, click the networks drop down, select custom network, and now enter the following information. You're going to need network name, new RPC URL, that whole thing, the chain ID, currency symbol, and the block explorer. And then you can manually add all the ERC20s that show up as you receive them. All right, so first you want to go into MetaMask. You want to create an account. Imagine you created an account. This is a completely fresh new account for me. So as you see here, I already added the testnet network. So I'll show you where to go. Open up the menu, go into settings, click on networks, add network, custom network, and you're going to put all that information in here. Click add, and you end up getting the Pulse Chain. You end up getting the Pulse Chain Testnet version 3. Okay, so once you do all that, you can rewind and watch it again if you don't get it or moving too fast. Once you get that, you're going to see TPLS added as a token. You'll see Pulse Chain Testnet version 3 at the top, as you can see up here, where you can switch networks. I'm using account 6. So what we're going to do is go into the faucet itself. Again, you're going to have to go back to that web page, click on the web page, copy and paste that web page in the browser here on your MetaMask browser. And then you should get, once you connect your account, click on the top little thing, find your account, click on it, and it'll automatically input the address into the request bar there. You can request once every 24 hours. So what I'm doing right now is I've made 6 accounts. So I'm going to make 10 total, and attempt to farm off of 10 wallets and maybe even more. If it continues to take longer, I might just keep making more. It'll take an extra, a day per account, but eventually it'll be worth it. So, you want to make sure the address is correct in there from the wallet that you're using. Click request. Once you click request, you should see a green little bar come up with your ad with the transaction ID in it. You can click X. If you hit it again, it won't let you. It'll tell you you've exceeded the rate limit. You have to wait basically 24 hours before you can try again. And that's for any wallet. Even if you put a new wallet in there, it won't let you do it. Okay, so then you go back to the wallet. It's pretty quick. You can see now it says 10 TPLS. So now you're gonna go back to that web page, the original pulsechain.com web page, and click on the stake link, and it'll take you to the PulseX DeFi page, Testnet DeFi page. Make sure you're properly connected to the right account. I'll make sure I do that now. Connect wallet. MetaMask. Okay, it's still not doing it properly. I'm on my old account. Okay, now the account's connected. So now so what you want to do is you want to exchange your 10 PLS. You want to do at least 5 or maybe even just 2. Well, let's just say 5 because the transaction cost is going to be at least 2. Okay, you're going to take 5 to swap it into the PLSX. Okay, and then again, the price is showing at 2.9 PLSX fee. Once you do it, all this stuff, don't need to know since this is a test net. Hit confirm swap, waiting for confirmation. The gas fee is going to come out of the TPLS that you already have, only 0.002 out of the 10. And it's going to cost you 5.002131 total. Okay, click that, confirm. Make sure you click on add PLSX to MetaMask. All right, add token, imported token, hit close. Wait for the transaction to go through automatically. And you'll see the balance on PLSX go from 0 to whatever you bought it with using your PLS. All right, so then you can go back to your wallet. And since you added the token to your wallet, it's showing here 14.48203 PLSX. Now we're going to go back to liquidity and stake it. Now we're going to click add liquidity, and you're going to select both tokens, PLS. And you're going to select PLSX. You're going to have to click on the balance. Click on the number where it says balance next to it for PLS. And you're going to get maxed out on how many you're allowed to do for PLS. Because here, adding liquidity, you're combining two coins together in order to receive what's called a liquidity pair token. An LP token. A liquidity pool token. Okay, so that's why I use, that's why I swapped out, exchanged 5 PLS for the amount of PLSX I got, because I only had another 5 sitting around. And that equated to however much I had sitting in the PLSX balance. Because keep in mind, whatever you have in PLS, it has to be the equivalent of what's sitting in your PLSX wallet. Okay, so now these two coins are going to combine together. We have to enable PLSX first. We have to approve it to be used by your wallet. That's why it's called DeFi. You have to give permissions for every little action to happen before you can actually utilize the networks. Okay. Now we're going to hit supply. And you verify that you have 4.98 PLS and 14.3253 PLSX. And all the other rate stuff, share the pool. Don't need to know any of that now. All we're here to do is knock out these tasks that they ask us to do, so we can hopefully receive the Pulse, the official mainnet Pulse chain tokens as an airdrop in the future. You hit confirm supply. Again, it's going to show the fee 0.01524 TPLS. You have plenty of that in your wallet. Hit confirm. And then you're going to want to add the new token that you're going to receive, the PLP token. Hit add token. Imported token. Hit close. And you're going to wait for the alert that the LP tokens have been given. Transaction receipt. Transaction done. You're now going to go into the wallet, and you can see that you've received 8.46 PLP tokens. So now, again, you can do this over and over. Every 24 hours, or if you can find a way to, I tried to clear the cache, and I tried a few other little tricks to do other, to access, you know, more, 10 more tokens. I actually haven't tried it on my laptop with a separate wallet. You can try it that way, but you have to wait every 24 hours to create a new account. I'm on account number 6 now. Follow that sequence I just showed you in this video, rewind it, and try it all over again, and hopefully you'll be part of the airdrop like I'm hoping for too. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to write. Got the Discord link at the bottom. Write me in the post itself, the video post comment itself, and help each other get through this airdrop. All right, thanks.